We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell of love no one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you. I can live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you.
Welcome to Caron Janko Wednesdays at Lunch Burger Edition. This week, Matthew and I went out to NDG. Been a while that we hadn't been to NDG.
Been a while. Been a while. Sure.
We went out on Summerled, a little past the Monkland Village, to go to Billy G's.
Sure did. Never heard of the place. Matthew, I know you were about to ask me if I ever heard of it, and I'm telling you right now, never.
Matthew, you didn't even anticipate how to spell the name of this place after I told you.
Did I not anticipate it?
I don't think so.
I thought about it in my head. I just assumed.
And it would be that it was Billy G apostrophe S.
Yeah, like Billy Gershwin or Billy Gargamel's.
But no, it's Billy G E E Z.
Like OGs.
Yeah. Billy G's.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Billy. but yeah, we went out to Villa Maria Metro. Got on a bus, rode that little bus for a while. Well, normal-sized bus. It wasn't a little bus. And hopped off to a little part of NDG I don't think I've ever actually been around on foot. Mm. And I guess a couple blocks away from places I have been on foot. But that's not the point.
Your feet never stepped in those specific spots.
That's right. That's right. And we walked up to Billy G's from a few feet away. It looked like they weren't even open because they had an ATM sign that was not lit up.
Everything inside was so dark, and we kind of gave up, but we still walked towards it just to...
Just in case.
Press our little faces against the glass.
Yeah, and I saw some movement there. I saw some men with hats. And we went right in, and there were like 5 people there.
Yeah.
Turns out Billy G's not much of a restaurant. Basically a little tavern of a bar type of place.
Oh, yeah.
That has a grill in the back, so they make food.
They do. They have a laminated menu. They're a restaurant.
Yeah, yeah. I guess they have a license probably to serve food.
I hope. Otherwise, we're calling them out.
So, Matthew, what was your first impression of Billy G's when we walked in?
Super glad it was not closed, but thought they could deal with a few more lights on, and I don't love light.
Okay. Okay.
I like a place that's dark, but not a dingy dark, you know? Like a warm dark.
Mm-hmm. I mean, this week we've been blessed with some sunny days for sunny ways. We had a really nice sunny day on Monday. I went up to the summit of Mount Royal, Beaver Lake, went and had a picnic there, sat on a towel, ate some sandwiches, got a bit of a sunburn.
Yeah. No, I can see it on your face. I see the red, more of a sunburn than when you went to Cuba. The Cuban sun
pretty much
did not burn you as harshly.
I think the difference is that when I went to Cuba, I was prepared. I wore a sunblock.
Yeah.
And, you know, in early April, I didn't expect the sun's rays in Montreal to be strong enough to burn my skin, especially not weeks after coming back from Cuba. I figured my skin would have developed some sort of
immunity?
Resistance, yes, to the sun. I was mistaken.
It's the same sun. The Cuban sun, the Canadian sun.
Yeah, but sometimes it's all about angles.
Yeah, but that sun knew. He got away from me once. I've been saving up these rays. Got a big old bag of Sever rays.
Yeah, just like close one eye and focus on me and dee 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 just shot its rays right at me. Like a ray gun.
Real harsh.
Solar ray gun.
No remorse. But you got one cheek that doesn't have as much of a redness. I feel like you were probably very in awe of something and you were just...
No, I was just...
A little fist over your cheek.
I was with the person I was with, we were mostly facing the sun, but I was turning to speak to her, so like the sun would hit one side of my face more than the other.
Were you often very surprised?
Only
enough for one hand.
Just to cover my face on one side. No, yeah,
not
really.
Not like Kevin McAllister scream, just a...
just slap one side of my face. Yeah. Ooh. No. Matthew, this is my first picnic of the year. First picnic in... I don't know if I went on a single picnic last summer. Matthew, what are your feelings on picnics? Have you ever had good picnics? What happens at a good picnic?
I don't like electronic picnics because I feel like they're too loud.
Have you ever been there?
No.
Picnic electronique?
I have not. I feel like they'd be very very noisy. What I like about a picnic is how quiet it is. Mm. I feel like I used to go on picnics, but I was never fully prepared. There was always something I would forget.
Absolutely the case for me.
And what are you going to do? You got a towel all laid out. You can't get up. Someone's going to steal your towel.
Mm. I suppose, yeah.
Yeah. Picnics are pretty good, though. I think I overdo it, though. I really just go nuts. Bring everything I can. Bring a lantern with me for when it gets dark.
Oh, wow.
Oh. I'll step it up. Bring a little barbecue next time.
I underestimated how much I needed for my picnic. I brought a melon, and I was like, okay, I'll bring a knife.
Wait, is that where you start? You think of picnic, and then you go melon.
No, sandwiches first.
Okay.
Sandwiches and drinks. And then I was like, maybe a melon. Oh, I've got prosciutto. Melon prosciutto is a great little snack. So I was like, okay, I'll bring a melon. Oh, I'm a smart guy. I'm going to bring a knife. Oh, I'm so proud of myself. I brought a knife. Didn't bring a cutting board. Didn't bring anything to put the melon's seeds in.
You throw them away.
Just where?
In the grass.
I guess.
They're seeds.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, I don't think a honeydew melon tree is going to grow on by Beaver Lake, though. I
thought you were pro-life. You want to just discard these seeds?
I thought I was pro-life. Jesus.
Well, pro-melons, you love them.
Sure. I'm pro-melons. I'm not going to say I'm pro-life.
I'm just putting words in your mouth.
Yeah, you sure are. But I realized pretty quickly that I was pretty underprepared. I had no napkins or anything. I was using the towel I was sitting on as my napkins. It could have gone a lot better. But
I saw your towel. It's not a picnic towel. You just brought a white
beach
towel.
It's a beach towel.
Not even a colorful one.
Oh, no, because that was the underside. That was the blank side.
If you're going to go on more picnics, you got to invest in a red and white checkered.
I know. Every time I see them, I go, oh, boy, I wish this was for my home so I could have Italian food or a picnic. It's one or the other.
Yeah.
But I figured a beach towel would do the trick.
Yeah.
It did. Yeah. Had a couple sandwiches, had a beer, had some melon prosciutto, had some Melba toast and cheese. Matthew, what's Melba? What's Melba mean?
If I had to guess, and I do.
In this case, you do.
I do definitely have to guess.
Because you don't know.
Toast, I know. That's just bread that has been warmed to a crispy texture.
Mm-hmm.
But that's regular size bread.
That's right.
Regular size toast. So yes. Melba must mean small. Little toast. So I feel like it's just a way to say little. Like you're...
But it's much crustier, like it's much harder and crunchier than toast.
Oh, well, that's the density is the same. It's like you take a...
shrink ray.
Yes, a shrink ray that keeps the mass.
Dee, 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 dee.
Condenses it.
So you shoot it with a shrink ray. It goes dee, 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 like the sun's ray. And you shrink it. Oh, yeah, that's a good ray sound. Yeah. Shrink it, toast it. Toast it first, shrink it first.
This is the age-old question. It'll take less energy to toast a Melba.
Smart.
But I think you'll get a more even toast if you toast a regular-sized toast.
Do you think Melba is just the person who came up with Melba toast?
I don't want to think that, but...
Do you think Melba makes for a better first name or last name?
Is that all that person does?
Maybe that's just their...
I made the little toasts?
Maybe that's their crowning achievement.
Yeah. Melba's definitely a better last name.
Yeah? So like Johnny Melba?
Yeah. Johnny Melba, anything that ends with a Y.
It couldn't be like Melba St. James.
Melba St. James. No, not at all.
No?
I wouldn't agree to that.
Do you think if Melba St. James married Johnny Melba, do you think that'd be possible? And Melba would definitely at that point make Melba toast. If Melba makes that toast, they go, what do we call it? It's pretty obvious. Melba toast.
But only toast. Just stop there. We only have one great idea, and it's tiny toast. We make toast for dollhouses.
We had some Melba toast and cheese. It was good. but more importantly, Matthew, you and I had a burger.
Yeah.
We walked into Billy G's, sat down, looked at the menu, top of the menu, burgers, in that grand. Way better than when we got to go looking around going, oh boy, I don't even know if they have a burger. Oh, here it is. Here's the one. This one had options. There was a burger, mm-hmm. cheeseburger, mm-hmm. a bacon cheeseburger, mm-hmm. something else. Oh, and a bacon burger.
Yeah.
And then you could double up each any of the burgers.
You could. Right away. Four options, but really eight.
No complications, no combos. You want onion rings? Let's do it. You want fries? Sure.
Yeah. It was a very easy order. No complications.
Nice and simple. Matthew, what'd you think?
Easy delivery.
What'd you think when you first started looking at that menu?
Thought it was a clean laminating job.
Mm-hmm. Have you laminated in the past, Matthew? I feel like you'd appreciate a good laminate.
Be a mess. I do appreciate a good laminate, especially when you don't get a little hair in, you don't get any dust particles in.
God, yeah.
You got to laminate it right away. You don't want any greasy little fingerprints.
Mm.
Good lamination job, good cutting job around the lamination. That's going to give this
These are
points.
Details that I don't notice. You're a next level lamination type of guy.
Yeah. The menu itself, you know, like you said, burgers right on the top, so I didn't even have to look mm-hmm. further than that.
It was pretty unremarkable as far as menu goes.
I mean, it's a menu just to let you know that there's some food to be had if you want it.
Because this little place, let's be honest, this place had what, like four or five tables up front, some seats along the bar, one little bathroom that like was just a toilet and a sink with a door. They had a jukebox, they had an ATM.
Microwave.
That was everything.
Saw a microwave in the back.
Okay. You know, they had a bunch of like... a hockey memorabilia up, a couple TVs, which is a lot for such a small place that they had more than one TV. You know, a signed football on display. They had a lot of little sports memorabilia and stuff. But yeah, I mean...
surprised you saw it and it was so dark in there.
The football in particular was lit up. It was in a lit up case.
Maybe that's why they keep it so dark, so the football stands out.
Really stands out, along with the Coke fridge. But yeah, I mean, it was a very simple little neighborhood bar. The menu, unremarkable. Not that that is a bad thing. The service...
It's easy to make choices.
It is easy to make choices.
I don't have to rack my brain about certain things.
Oh, I don't want this, don't want that. Here's four options. You want double burger or not, whatever. You want fries? Here we go. Soda, sure. Coffee, beer, whatever.
Don't go there expecting a Pepsi, though, because you are going to be disappointed.
Well, you know, a lot of places are Coke places.
I love Pepsi.
Some places are Pepsi places.
I wasn't disappointed.
Well, I mean, we are in Montreal, Quebec. Ici, c'est Pepsi. Not always.
You think they have the cola police that come in? Because I know some places can only serve Coke. Some places only serve Pepsi products.
That's right. It's because they signed an exclusive contract.
Yes. Do you think there's a... You think there's the cola police to come in?
Well, it's not the cola police. Let's say Coke... Coke provides you with all your products, and then Coke shows up to be like, hey, by the way, what's with all this damn Pepsi? They might be like, well, you signed an exclusive contract.
I feel like there'd have to be a third party, like an arbitrator of some sort. And I'm not talking RC Cola. They shouldn't be coming in there trying to get their beaks wet because it's...
Oh, yeah, they should.
Matthew,
I'm a long-time fan of the Royal Crown since 1903.
Yeah.
It is possibly my favorite soda.
Just because it's 50 cents cheaper than the other sodas?
I'll take it back. My favorite cola.
Hmm.
Not soda. Not just that. I like, there's something classy about it. It's a Royal Crown. It's not just Pepsi or Coca.
Now, you know, then they...
Royal.
Mm. Are they the ones that have red cans and blue cans?
No, they have blue cans.
They have blue cans. So they're after something. Pick your own color.
Well, they are in taste closer to a Pepsi Cola than a Coca-Cola. In price, closer to free than a Pepsi Cola.
I know when I go to people's houses, picnics, get-togethers, and I open a cooler, like, oh, go grab yourself a Pepsi out of that cooler. I'm like, this party is off the hook because there's a lot of people here, and to afford that many Pepsis, and I was like, they got to be doing something right. And I open it up.
Well, you buy them in bulk. It's not that bad.
And I open it up, though, and I grab one of these ice-cold Pepsis, and I see this is an RC Cola.
This, I get excited.
This party is a sham.
Well, either that or it is more of a kingly party than you would have expected.
Now, that's the moment I realize, like, they suckered me into this place, and it's like, now I won't be able to get out.
Well, now that I have the RC Cola in my hand, I'm not getting out of here alive.
That's the part in the movie where you realize, like, I've been duped. It's a trap, and you have the cola in your hand, and it's over.
You just... crack it open and like pretending to sip it, but you're just pouring it on the ground.
It's like I forgot something in my car.
Yeah. Oh. So